what Seriki Fulani said again that causes reaction online. The Seriki Fulani of Ibarapa area of Oyo State has caused reactions again online as The Punch reports what he said concerning the issue of Fulani herdsman Sunday Igbo and his eviction from Iganga town in Oyo State. The Seriki Fulani was asked a series of questions during an interview with a Punch correspondent, of which he answered accordingly. Recall that a Yoruba activist, Chief Sunday Adeyemo, who is popularly known as Sunday Igboho, and his followers allegedly evicted the Seriki Fulani of Ibarapa area of Oyo following the allegation of killings, raping, and kidnapping for ransom. Sunday Igboho and his followers allegedly chased away Seriki Fulani after the 7 days ultimatum which was given to them expired. Seriki Fulani said that all the allegations that he was kingpin to kidnapped are false and added that anyone with evidence should come and prove it to his face. He said the person should name anywhere he has negotiated with to release a kidnapped victim. He also added that he was the one who always reported the cases of kidnappings of both Yoruba and Fulani in the area. He explained further that the majority of kidnapping victims are Fulani and he can and will not give up until 24 hours, while Yoruba victims are lesser than four. He also said that it was a collaboration of both Fulani and Yoruba to kidnap Fulani herdsmen in the area. Seriki Fulani also claimed that he has never met with Sunday Igboho, added that one Jambele invited him to Iganga. He also denied the allegation that they shot as Sunday Igboho. He said if they have a gun, they would have to retaliate when they were evicted from the town. He added that none of his children know how to shoot. All that, he said, has caused reaction online. Okay, let's quickly see what the people are saying online. Okay, this person is saying that useless man talking rubbish. I thank God my Yoruba people have risen up from their slumber. Okay. This is another person. He said, this man is complete professional liar, a deceitful person, a manipulator, and the chief grand patron of liars in Nigeria. He will lie and still give you fake tears. It is obvious this union isn't beneficial. It isn't beneficial to an average citizen. All right, my viewers. Whether he's telling the truth or he's telling a lie, that is his own cup of tea. The most important thing that is that he has been evicted out of Oyo. So he should just go and rest. Wherever he is, he should remain there. They are not interviewing him for him to be asked to return back to Oyo. He is claiming now that he doesn't know Sunday Igboho. Okay? He doesn't know Sunday Igboho, but the day Sunday Igboho came to report the issue to him, it was Sunday Igboho himself and his boys that came to meet him facially, face to face. After Sunday Igboho reported the issue to him, the next thing they did was to shoot at Sunday Igboho. Okay, what made Sunday Igboho to react, if not because his boys shot at him? Yes, now, there can never be smoke without fire. Sunday Igboho reacted as a result of the attack. So what is he talking about? Why the denial? In fact, the Oyo crisis began from that this Fulani or Seriki Fulani of Oyo. That is where the crisis began. That is where Sunday Igboho got angry and started his attack. So why is he lying? Why is he lying? He has been evicted. So asking him all these things will not make them to return him back to Oyo. You understand? So let us just let him be. If he like, he should be telling lie. That is his own cup of tea. The most important thing is that Oyo is cleaned up. He has been evicted with his family. Okay, see what has happened to him now. Okay, you've not met Sunday Igbo, and Sunday Igbo boys have to come to your house and destroy some of your properties. Something gave birth to something. If nothing happened between him and Sunday Igbo, what will run Sunday Igbo to boys to come and set his cows and his house ablaze? Okay, Sunday Igbo is now telling a lie, huh? Okay. That is some cup of tea, and that is what he feels. The most important thing is that Oyo is at peace now. Peace is gradually returning to Oyo as Fulani X-Men are returning back to their hometown. To their hometown, which is, to me, is the best, at least, to save lives. To save lives, which is the best. Alright? So, my dear viewers, I don't know. You see, one thing about these Fulani herdsmen is that they don't want, you can forgive them, but don't allow them in your vicinity again. If you give them a chance now, I bet you regret ever giving them that chance at the first place. You regret it. They don't give them opportunities. They don't. The poor people don't try it because of that attitude and behaviors. You understand? They don't. So let us not give in to their trick. Let us not give in to their lies. Okay? So whether he's telling the truth or he's telling a lie, that is his own cup of tea. Let us not allow that to affect us. You understand? So far he knows that there is a war in Oyo, and in the process of the war, his house and his cows were burnt, and he was chased out of Oyo. Kabi? So that is just it. So whether he's telling the truth or he's telling a lie, that is his own wahala. Okay? Maybe he's formulating all these lies, thinking that after the interview, he will be asked to return back to Oyo. The impossibility. Where? I'm not sure Sunday Igbo's boys will even want to see his type. You know why I suspect what this Fulani man is saying is a lie? When the female commissioner of police, Onadeko, came to Oyo with Sunday Igbo, the woman, any house they enter, they keep pointing finger at this Sereke Fulani, that he is the one perpetrating all those evil kidnapping and raping of people. So why would people be pointing fingers at him when they know that if truly he is not doing all those things? Is that possible? So that's it. So please, my dear viewers, give me free to leave your comment below the comment section. Click on the subscription buttons as well as the bell buttons to get updated whenever we upload any new videos. Thank you.